Yuri.
I'm Jacob.
We're going for a drive. 2019 Volkswagen Jetta.
GLI with launch control.
Ready?
Oh, I'm ready. I don't know if the car was ready.
Okay, so lots of tire squealing.
Lots, like every single time.
And then it automatically upshifted for me in manual mode.
Yeah, so I will never give this a 0 to 100 kilometer per hour time because it won't work any single time.
Okay, so let me downshift quickly into second and floor it. Oh, I missed the upshift. It's pretty quick with just one person in here. It's definitely zippy.
It's the same drivetrain as the GTI, so let's get into it.
Horsepower and torque.
228 horsepower, 258 pound-feet of torque from a 2-liter turbo four-cylinder.
So why isn't this called a Jetta GTI?
Because it's never been called that.
GLI has always been for Jetta, GTI has always been for GTI.
For Golf, which just became the GTI.
Okay, cool.
Yes.
So the first thing I noticed when I got in here, we've got a new gauge cluster setup.
Yeah, it's all digital and it looks really nice.
But it kind of looks like Audi. We've got the gas gauge on the right, we've got the temperature on the left, the way it kind of shows the lights through there.
Is that a problem?
No, but I just noticed that like, everything Audi did 3 years ago, Volkswagen gets. Like, I jumped into an older Audi, and I'm like, oh, it's a Volkswagen. I'm like, nope, it's just got old Audi gauges, which were current Volkswagen at the time.
That's exactly what happens, and it makes sense.
So the gauges are very clear. We've got kind of like race-style gauges in this.
Oh, I just love the lack of lag.
Yeah, like all the animations, everything is crisp. And when you downshift, not only are the downshifts quick, but the animations are quick too.
Yeah, everything about the gauges is great. They nailed them. Well, except one thing that you found about the maps.
Okay, if you click the map view in the middle, it looks like it's been rendered through like Photoshop JPEG on quality one.
It's still cool that you can do that because that's like a very luxurious feature.
But like,
yeah, I know.
What a miss.
I know.
And what I also like is when you click the view button, you can minimize it so literally nothing is showing. This is my dream, right?
I think this is the most minimalistic display I've ever seen for you.
Like, this is great. The only thing that sucks is that it shows your speed twice and yeah. I tried to get rid of everything in the middle and I couldn't. So unlike Audi, this does not have a reduced display, but I'm sure in 3 years it will.
But it kind of has its own reduced display without being called reduced display.
And then if you click view again, you've got this other mode where you have pretty much all your information set up. Very cool. And then the next thing I noticed in here, which was a complaint from pretty much every other Volkswagen I've ever driven.
Your complaint.
Well, it must have been everyone's complaint if they fixed it. The infotainment is up at the top. There's no more vents above it.
Yeah, and they actually integrated it into the dash, so great job.
Yeah, because like that was my problem, was I was always looking down at the footwell to use infotainment. Like, it's so great that my criticisms were correct. And then to quickly end off on this infotainment, doesn't have rewinding satellite radios. It does have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, which works perfectly.
They still haven't fixed the rotating volume knob.
That's only for Audis. They get the fix.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe in 3 years.
3 years. And one thing that I want to complain about is the lag in this infotainment, which doesn't match the lag of the gauge cluster because the gauge cluster has no lag. So when you put this into the gauge mode to see your cool gauges, they're just so laggy compared to the RPM gauge.
And then it runs your horsepower in kilowatts?
Yeah.
KWs?
Which you guys apparently don't use in Europe, and you got mad when we said that, so it's here in a North American vehicle from Germany. I'm sure you can change that through the settings, but then you gotta put it in like US American, then you'll probably end up in like gallons and
Out. But what's also cool about this infotainment is we have the app button that'll go right to your Apple CarPlay or Android Auto display. I gotta talk about the reverse camera. It's not centered.
Okay, a little bit.
So for normal backing up, when you're not going into a spot, that's easy. But I started backing up and I felt like it wasn't on the right axis and it really bothered me because it doesn't pop out of the logo like Golf's.
I think seeing the tops of the trunk and the corners is kind of funny.
And I'm gonna give it a little boot through cliche corner because this is technically a sporty car, right?
Of course it is. This is a GLI. It's kind of like a GTI.
Okay, lots of tire noise. It's not gripping super hard.
Yeah, no, it's not at all.
But I think it is pretty zippy. You know what I mean? Like, it's not like the wildest.
It's a GTI drivetrain. I'll get to the handling later because there are some complaints about it, but yeah, it's very close to a GTI, but it's not quite like a GTI.
Especially with the paddles over a manual transmission, which this can come with.
Yeah, so this is the 7-speed DSG, and I think they kind of ruined it a little bit.
And the biggest way they ruined it is that it forces upshifts no matter what.
Yeah,
The paddles are meant for downshifting, and that's it. So look, down to second.
And it downshifts so fast. There was an auto upshift.
And I didn't even have time to get to 6,500 where the red line is. It automatically shifts me up ahead of time. And I'm in like sport mode, everything off.
It just never lets you get to actual redline, and by the time you tried to, it would have already upshifted for you if you were trying to upshift yourself.
And that's why I think this version isn't for real car guys. I think it's for car guys in the making, old car guys, or almost car guys.
I think this is still for car guys. I just think Volkswagen kind of screwed up that part of it. But just to be clear, the transmission still shifts very, very quickly. It's just the feel of it and the automaticness of it.
Yeah, I don't think I really remember the GTI even shifting this fast.
Yeah, so you kind of lose the fartiness, but you get faster shifting.
Okay, and then my next little issue, the pumped in audio.
What's wrong with it?
I think it sounds really good. I think it sounded a lot better on the Golf R because the Golf R was so much faster.
Like, okay.
I think they need to dial it down a bit, but it is pretty cool. But if we set up our custom to not have the fake sound on, we can toggle it like this.
I really like it.
It's definitely a lot better than the Ford Edge ST.
Oh my God, way better.
But like, I'm fine without it.
I think it adds this little layer of like WRX-ness to it, and I still really like it.
So I guess how you set up every drive mode to have softer steering and softer suspension, but still the sport engine, I want to set up this one so that I don't have the fake pumped in audio and everything else sport.
I understand that. I just think with it on, it kind of sounds like it has like cold air intake-ish.
Okay, let's listen through cliche.
Okay, once again. That auto upshift got you.
Forced upshift way too soon. So before I get you in the driver's seat, let's run through the same old tests we always do.
Here we go, visor test.
3, 2, 1. And it
what? Volkswagen, explain yourselves.
Yeah, mine didn't fall off though.
Come on. You know what, Volkswagen? I think you're gonna have to donate yourselves one of these visor test shirts because this is ridiculous.
All right, we've got a medium cup of gas station coffee. Fits just fine. Then no box test because this isn't a hatch. Save that for the Arteon.
I'm so upset. Like, I'm so upset. The Beetle did that.
Yeah, the Beetle did that too. And then
the
Veloster.
The Beetle Coupe did that, but not the convertible.
And then the Veloster too.
What's with this stuff?
All right, your turn to drive.
All right.
Launch control?
Of course. Just gonna let it auto upshift.
The tire squealing's kind of cool though. I didn't expect that out of the GLI.
Yeah. So let's talk about this drivetrain. Same drivetrain as in the GTI, so I still do really like it. Feels pretty punchy. Lots of low-end torque. I like it. And like we said earlier, transmission shifts very quickly. This is front-wheel drive, but we do have a locking electronic front diff. So you can actually adjust that through the modes in the car settings. So I'm going to send it through cliche corner now. There is some body roll. It's noticeably softer than the GTI. Like, everything about how this handles and how this feels is softer than the GTI, even if you put it in sport mode. So we do have the adaptive suspension in this one, which I don't think the Americans get unless they get the 35th anniversary version, I think. I could be wrong. But anyways, this one does have it, and it does make a little bit of a difference between the modes. I don't know if it's that necessary because it's not that sporty in sport mode.
Yeah, I haven't really noticed much difference from any of the modes in general.
That's
besides
exactly
throttle response on Eco.
Yeah, and then obviously the sound, which is
the sound, yeah.
Yeah.
So if we click our mode button, we got Eco, Comfort, Normal, and Sport and Custom.
Yeah, Custom's great. Just leave it in Custom, basically.
Yeah, and like if you need to save gas, Eco really mutes that pedal, and like it'll save you a lot more gas. If you're driving manual in Sport, like, you'd probably go through enough fuel.
You probably would, but I think this thing's relatively fuel efficient. And this is a DSG, so it is a dual clutch. We can put it in drive or sport, or put it in manual, but you still get the fake upshifts and whatnot.
And then it's still down for down, up for up, so they got that wrong.
Yeah, and with overall driving, the actual driving position, it's relatively low. I really like that.
I really like how comfortable the seats are.
The seats are way more comfortable than the GTI seats, which I actually don't like because the GTI seats are more bolstered, so I wish these were a little bit more bolstered.
Yeah, but
These are more comfortable.
If the paddles automatically force you to upshift, they don't deserve bolstering.
This is just generally an overall more comfortable car than the GTI.
Yeah, and like these seats are like super comfortable, like so much comfort in the lumbar.
It's true. And there's actually some bolstering in the back seats, which I noticed, which I fit reasonably behind because this is longer than the GTI. And I think a lot of that goes to rear leg room. So I actually have way more leg room in this than I do the GTI.
I don't really like front wheel drive sedans.
Why?
You can only reach a certain amount of horsepower and they're never too cool. Like the ISF, that was cool. The Chevy SS, that was cool.
ISF was rear wheel drive.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
That's why rear wheel drive is cool for four-door sedans, and front wheel drive sedans don't really do it for me.
Okay. What about front wheel drive hot hatches?
That's cool.
Okay, but this is the same thing, sort of, minus the hatch.
Yeah, but I guess maybe it's a look, maybe it's an image thing. thing is, they don't make like rear-wheel drive V8 hot hatches.
No, they don't.
But they do make rear-wheel drive V8 sedans. So I think that's the split.
All right, fair enough. Because like the Passat GT, we both didn't enjoy that as much as we thought we would.
And then when we drove the Arteon, it was like, all right, this is just a Passat with a hatch.
Which is kind of cool.
But it, yeah, it looks cool, but it doesn't go any faster.
No, not really.
Like, what's the fastest front-wheel drive sedan? Let us know in the comments.
Yeah, let us know, because I can't think of one right now.
And speaking of image, I kind of want to talk about that commercial for this Jetta GLI.
Go for it.
Okay, everyone saw it. It's got the car drifting and stuff. It starts with a reverse J-turn, and then it just got like, car is modified. So they put a hydraulic e-brake on it and just did cool stuff.
I think the Hoonigans guys filmed that, but they made it look like everybody filmed it with their own cell phone.
Well, whoever filmed it, cool. But whoever was like behind the idea of it, like, man, they were just like, every time it was an e-brake turn, you can just tell they wouldn't see the rear wheels locking up.
What e-brake?
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. Like, I think that was a bad way to advertise how cool this car is, because that car is not this cool. But we should test out the e-brake on gravel to see if it actually works.
Okay, because we do have a little flicky flick of an e-brake.
Maybe that commercial was 100% accurate.
And we will let you know right now.
All right, e-brake me.
Give it a little flick. That was horrible.
So that was 100% not the commercial?
No.
All right, just checking.
Did you get that?
Car has been modified. Not this one.
I mean, they did say vehicle modified, but
I would have to go a lot faster.
That's cheating.
Yeah.
And don't fast forward footage in commercials.
No.
Okay, I'm gonna try an e-brake turn with a regular e-brake in my GTI. So let me know in the comments below if that commercial made this car seem a lot cooler than we're making it seem right now. Because I feel like we're being realistic about it.
Oh yeah, I would never dream of drifting this thing or doing anything stupid with it.
Exactly, that commercial bothers me. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Save that much effort for something cooler.
Yeah, they made it seem way cooler than it is.
Yeah,
it's true.
I was literally rattled. I was making Instagram posts when I saw it. Like, yeah, sorry, I'm a little worked up.
I saw that, that's okay. So since this is very similar to the GTI and we keep mentioning the GTI, I would like to talk about some similarities and differences.
Hit me with it.
Number one, I'm pretty sure you can't get cooled seats on a GTI, and this has cooled seats, which is awesome. However, next to the cool seats, I'm kind of hitting against this hard plastic, which I don't really like. Next GTI difference is this actually has memory seats, which is pretty cool. So if you share this with somebody, you're gonna really appreciate that.
On the driver's side?
Yes, only, because that's manual adjustment.
And any other interior stuff you like?
One last thing that was different is they actually deleted some gloss black from this one compared to the GTI. So this has fake carbon fiber, and I'm okay with it because it's not gloss black.
And since this is a GLI, we've got red lines everywhere. So in the interior, we have red ambient lighting, like on the door sill, underneath this whole dash, and in the cell phone charging area, which is very, very nice.
So you think they did ambient lighting very well for this price?
Oh yeah.
That's good.
Especially since it's a GLI and it's got the red matching stuff.
So last thing, let's get into the looks. I think this looks pretty good.
Definitely really, really good. Probably better than most Volkswagens right now.
Yeah. Like, it's just really sharp lines. And it's just not over the top, again, like Volkswagen likes to do, but they got this really nice lip kit all the way around, which you notice as well.
Yeah, I guess that's the GLI kind of thing. But it, like, it's the appropriate amount of looks for the speed, I think.
Yeah, and then we got really nice headlights, LEDs.
Yeah, the headlights look awesome. And I feel like I saw reverse of that on an Audi that was slightly older on my way here, so I guess they're recycling that as well. But they look really good. I call it the staple.
Okay. I can see that.
And the grille looks nice, the GLI logo looks good.
And then we also have a red line, which the red line means something on the GLI, kind of like the Passat GT tried to do, but this is actually like a real red line.
And then our side body line is very, very crisp. Such good shadows and reflections.
And what do you think of the wheels?
They're good. They're very Volkswagen.
They are very Volkswagen. I think they could have done a little bit better, but they are appropriate for this vehicle.
I mean, my favorite Volkswagen wheels are the ones on my GTI that I just bought.
Those are my favorite too, to be honest. The like phone dial style, I forget what they're called.
But what is the Continental recommended tire for the Jetta GLI?
The Extreme Contact DWS 06. Wait, so are you a GTI guy now?
I don't know, I own one.
All right, guess so.
So what do you think of the taillights?
I do like them. I wasn't sure about the squares at first, but they're unique.
I like how there's amber in it.
Yeah, that part I'm not really sure about. I kind of don't like it, but I also like it because it's different.
A lot of cars didn't have amber for like the last 10 years, and now people are slowly bringing it back and it's making it cool.
Yeah, exactly. Just like my Raptor amber headlights. And what Volkswagen also got right, the actual exhaust tips are real.
Well, Volkswagen's a company that does exhaust tips incorrectly sometimes as well. Take one.
Yeah, sometimes.
So that's pretty good that they nailed it.
And Audi sometimes brutalizes them recently.
But then they also sometimes do a really good job.
On the RSs.
So like,
Yeah,
you know,
it's all over the board.
It's nice that this one was a win.
And then we got a nice little lip spoiler, and that's pretty much it for the looks.
Yeah, I'm kind of disappointed we didn't get this in red, but I think the gray looks very good as well.
Oh, the gray is so appropriate for this, but yeah, I agree. Yeah, the red is red on red looks good.
Because the red line pops more on the gray, but like, exactly. I guess maybe because the commercials were red, and I know how cool it looks in the commercial.
So they got you.
When it's fully modified with e-brakes and stuff.
Yeah, so they got you with the commercial, so it worked.
No, they got me. They got me worked up because like it shows how cool this car can be if they made it rear-wheel drive with some more horsepower, a manual transmission, and an e-brake.
Yeah, that's right.
You know?
I know. Couple more things before we get to the price, all of the things in front of me. The steering wheel itself feels great, nice and thin, same buttons that you'd find on basically any other Volkswagen. Paddles still feel just as cheap, and this does have adaptive cruise.
Well, I think the paddles are the right amount of cheapness for the way the transmission acts.
Okay, fine.
And then in adaptive cruise, we have lane departure assist, but it's not lane keep assist, it's not lane centering, but the Audi had awesome lane centering, so hopefully in 3 years.
Well, they gotta save some price somewhere, so let's get to the price.
Hit me with it.
$34,090.
Canadian.
This is for the non-35th anniversary with the optional adaptive cruise package.
So this is kind of competition for a Civic Si and an Elantra GT Sport.
Oh, absolutely this is.
I don't think I'd pick this over them, but if I was into German cars, I would probably pick this over them.
I think I would take this over the Elantra Sport, no question, because of the looks of the current Elantra Sport with its triangles.
Yeah, the triangles are weird, but like I actually kind of like that Hyundai is doing different things across their line. Not every single car looks exactly the same.
I get that too, but this just looks better overall, like way better. I think this even looks better than the Civic Si, but I think the Civic Si drives better than this.
Yeah, yeah. I would like to see the triangle Elantra GT Sport with some like body kit and stuff. You know what I mean? Like, I bet you there's a really cool triangular shaped body kit for it now.
Maybe.
So let us know if you would take the Jetta GLI and if you were tricked by the commercial on how cool this car actually is.
Don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell.
Patreon.com/straightpipes and Teespring for cool shirts.
Yo,
I need to order one of those. That's wicked.
Just don't test that visor.